Faye. What's up, guys? I'm back with another Love Link Guide video. It took a while for me to get this video out. I apologize for that. I was doing the skill quest for level 80 and Firelands 3 and Ice Spear 3. You have to get a water bead and a fire bead for both of them, and it took me forever to get the beads. I even leveled in the process. It was crazy. It took a very long time. In fact, I think it took me a longer time to get those two beads than it took me to get to level 80. Okay, now there's two different quests that you can take at level 80, and you can use both of these quests to grind with until 100. The first quest I'm going to show you, I highly advise you do not do this quest alone. You do have to kill a boss for this quest, and the boss is kind of hard. So unless you're extremely well geared or you have an HP set and a pet, I really, really suggest you do it with other players. Otherwise, you're going to have a hard time. All right, so the quest is called Awaiting the Goddess. You'll have to kill three different mobs, and then you'll have to kill the boss. I'm going to show you where the mobs are, and then I'm going to show you the boss. I'll even fight the boss for you so you guys can see how difficult she is. So, yeah, this is the first quest. Like I said, there is another quest I'll be showing you that you can take at level 80. It's much easier than this quest. You only have to kill 50 mobs. It does give less XP when you turn it in, but it's a lot easier than this quest. So it's completely up to you what you want to do. Alright, so you have to kill 30 of these guys. And oh, another thing about these guys, they drop mini honeywas. And you can use them to get a pet. So while you're doing this quest or whatever, hopefully you'll get a couple of them. You can throw them on your island and then you can get a pet. So yeah, just a fun fact there. Now this boss, she isn't too hard if you have a pet and you have like healing items and stuff. And like I said, if you're really well geared, but, you guys gotta keep in mind, the gear that I'm using for this, little nub right now is my High Wizard's gear. So I'm extremely geared for a level 80. And I know not all of you are going to have that same advantage. Okay, so these are leopards. You're going to need to kill 30 of these as well. And there should be some Ganos up here. There was Ganos on the second map as well, but I figured I'd just show them to you all on the same map. Yeah, these are Ganos. You'll have to kill 30 of these too. Oh, I should have used Ice Spear on him. So 30 leopards, 30 Ganos, and 30 Alberos, and then you have to kill the boss as well. And then once I kill the boss, I'll go ahead and I'll take you guys to the second quest that you can take at level 80, which is, like I said, a lot easier. It's more doable. You can solo that quest. I really wish I would have been able to, actually record the entirety of me grinding so you guys could see how fast, it is. It doesn't take long at all, which is why I'm so astounded, because, like, some people, they'll sit at, like, you know, they'll go to bombs, or they'll go to three eyes, or, you know, wherever they go to beg for levels. And they'll sit there and they'll beg for levels for like an hour. And in that hour, they could have already been the level that they wanted to be. Like, it's insane. Okay, so this is the boss. I'm gonna go ahead and use a paralysis vaccine and a poison vaccine because she does both. I would highly suggest if you plan on doing this quest that you also have them. Otherwise, it's gonna be a little harder. All right. I'm actually probably even gonna die in this fight. I'm not gonna lie. She can be hard. She can hit hard. Even though she's also magic, you would think that she would be a little weaker, but that's not the case at all. Also, if you're a high wizard, I would drain about, I don't know, like halfway through, because your drain is going to end before you kill her. Oh, I knew I was gonna die. Alright, so as you can see, she's not the easiest fight. So, I would do that with a party if you're gonna do it. Oh, also, people had asked me about these two skills. I'm gonna use the one here in a second, so I thought I'd bring them up. This right here, oh, I can't do it because I don't have enough XP. Or MP, I mean. This is spell boost. This makes you do more damage to mobs. Let's see if there's one around here. No, there's not. Anyways, but it makes whatever skill you use then afterwards do more damage, like twice the amount of damage that it would normally do. But it also increases the MP cost of that skill as well. So keep that in mind. And this right here, this is Escape. This is also a pet skill. I would suggest getting both of them if you're a high wizard or even a bishop or whatever. I would suggest having Spell Boost. And Escape you can have for any class. I would highly suggest getting it. You can use Escape at any time. You could be in the middle of a fight, and all you have to do is click that button. It'll immediately take you to the last town you were in. It doesn't matter. You could be doing something, and you can still use it. So, yeah. Alright, now this second quest I was telling you about. There's actually three different mobs that you pick to choose from. But, I would highly suggest you just pick the Medusas, because they're a lot easier than the other two. The Medusas don't give as much, experience as what you would get for the other two, but the other two, are a lot harder. Like, they'll hit you a lot harder. The survivability chance of that you have with Medusas is a lot higher than with the other two. The other two are called Baphomet and Evil Swords, and the quest itself is called Evil Vibes. So you're gonna take it at Satirica. I would suggest just doing the Evil Vibes quest over Waiting the Goddess. It's less time consuming and it's not as hard. It'll go by pretty quick. Like I said, the experience you get from this quest is probably about half the amount of what you get from Awaiting the Goddess. Awaiting the Goddess, I think, is 355,000. I believe that's how much it is. And this quest will give you, I think, 136 or 138,000. Once you turn it in. But you'll get this quest done a lot quicker, and like I said, it's a lot easier. So you come over here, and this is where you take the quest at. Like I said, there's three different mobs that you could choose from. I would suggest doing the Medusas if you're a high wizard or a bishop, or if that's what you're gonna become, at least. Because they're a magic class, or they're a magic mob. so they won't do as much damage to you as what the evil swords and the Baphomets were. Now, I'll show you where the evil swords and Baphomets are in case you decide to do those quests instead, since they give more XP. But I don't recommend it. You'll want to do these two quests until 100. Now, awaiting the goddess, because it gives like almost 400,000 experience, you could actually keep doing awaiting the goddess after 100. You could do awaiting the goddess until, you know, 110, 120 if you wanted, but once you hit like 120, you can go somewhere else to like a really high leveled mob that you'll actually be able to kill, and you can just grind that for a while. Okay, so these right here are the Medusas. You'll kill 50 of these, and then you'll turn the quest in, you'll take the quest again, come back and do it again, and you'll do that until you're level 100. And if you don't want to do the Medusas, then you can do the evil swords. I'll show you where they're at. They're in the back here. And the Baphomets, they're on the second page, or the second map, I mean, so you'll have to, right here, these are the evil swords. Luckily it didn't hit me too hard. I actually have quite a bit of it, though, so I have, like, a higher defense than what most of you guys are gonna have. Okay, the Baphomets are over here. They should be around this corner. Yeah, okay, so right here are the Baphomets. You can also do 50 of these as well. So you can do evil swords, Medusas, or the Baphomets. Baphomets and evil swords, I believe they give more experience than the Medusas. But, they hit a little harder, and if you don't have as much of it as what I have, it could probably be pretty bad for you. So I would suggest doing the Medusas, but if you have an HP set or you have a lot of it or whatever and you want to do this, if you're geared, you can go ahead and do these too. Alright guys, well, that's it for the video. Remember, you can do either of these two quests to 100. If you're doing Awaiting the Goddess, you can do it to 120. I hope this video helped you guys, and as always, thanks for watching. See you in the next video, guys. Bye.